But today, we are, this segment here, we are talking about beer. Beer up in Sonoma County, and what one company in particular is doing to help out the Redwood Empire Food Bank of Sonoma County through, really, I've heard about spent grains from breweries being donated to farmers and such, but never in this fashion. So I thought, well, you know what? Let's have the guy behind it on, brewmaster Rich Norgrove with Bear Republic Brewery. That is in Cloverdale, northern Sonoma County. He's joining us right now to talk a little bit about it. Hey, Rich.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
Yeah, good morning to you, too. Great. And I really like what you're doing there at Bear Republic. So explain how this works. You take the spent grains, and then what happens to them?
Well, you know, basically what we've got is a byproduct that if I was a larger brewery, say in a metropolitan area, I'd have to dispose of into a landfill. And Cheryl has been working with us. She's the farmer out in Knights Valley, literally since the day we opened our brewery, and she has kind of got a lock on the smaller breweries in the area. She goes over to St. Helena and then also picks up from our pub all of the spent grain. So take the best grain you possibly could purchase in the world to make beer with, and then you've removed all of its sugars, and you basically have this pure protein source that needs to be utilized basically within 24, 48 hours, or it starts to go bad on you in turn. And they figured out how to do it, how to supplement their feed source and provide their cattle with some nutrients, and then it also allows me to not have to dump it into a landfill. So it's kind of a win-win for everybody.
And there's nothing wrong with the grain as far as removing the sugars that isn't necessary to be used as feed then? Just the protein is what's needed?
Pretty much. At this, you know, the type of malt that's utilized in making beer is like the top 2 to 3% of all the malt in the world.
Oh.
It goes through a secondary process. So they re-germinate the malt, and that allows the sugars to be broken down in the malt kernel, and then it's kilned and dried. And that's how a brewer gets his malt. And so there's usually a base two-row malt, which makes up, you know, every recipe has some two-row in it. And then there's these specialty malts that we buy. It could be rye malt, it could be different types of crystal malts, black malts, all those things that give beer its real special flavors. And once I've taken everything I needed out of it, which is removing the sugars, and you know, we have obviously a special brew house that allows us to do that. It's called a mash tun, the big vessel that this all happens in. Once those sugars are removed, it creates a sugar water called wort, and then you add your yeast and hops at different times, and you go through the fermentation process, and you have beer. Well, once I've removed that sugar, I've basically got grain, spent grain, we call it, that is a wonderful protein source. And so, you know, Cheryl has a Black Angus breeding program is what she does. She actually sells her cattle every year for breeding stock. And working with her, it just became a way for her to actually, you know, purchase a little less feed, allow us to, again, not throw it in the landfill. You know, if we were a brewery in San Francisco, we'd be having to figure out how to dump it. In this case, you work directly with the farmer, and the farmer's driving out to the brewery, you know, every single day, so it's very much a synergistic relationship. She has to know our brew schedule. If we get too far behind on our brew schedule, we're affecting the cow's feeding schedule.
Right. So,
you know, it's a partnership.
Everyone has to be together. And, you know, we've kind of expanded this out a little bit as our capacity's grown to where we have a farmer in Petaluma that actually takes it and feeds it to their goats. And then there's wonderful goat cheese that is served at our pub and restaurant, you know, on a little charcuterie plate. So it's one of the really neatest relationships I can honestly say I have of all the years of Bear Republic being around, because Cheryl has this beautiful portion of Sonoma County that she has been in her family for multiple generations, and it's the coolest thing. I mean, these cows know when the trucks are showing up.
See the smiles on their faces. Rich, what's the connection then with Cheryl and the Redwood Empire Food Bank? How does this meat then get to needy families?
Well, what Cheryl put together, and she's the main catalyst of this, is that she started to realize there was a way, you know, her breeding cattle for such a long time, it really wasn't something that she was used to doing to be making, you know, breeding cattle to be used as food.
Mm-hmm.
And she really does love her cattle, like almost like pets. And so she took this to the next step and has gone ahead and asked several other, you know, ranchers in the area to donate heads of cattle to her. And then what she does is she basically raises them on her farm and then is taking this all the way, you know, from the beginning of the process to the feed, which is what we're providing, all the way down to getting people to donate the butchering, and then it goes directly to the food bank. So for me, it's kind of, I joke sometimes because it's, we like to say the beer starts, you know, from the farm to the brewery to the table, and now we're going back to the farm, and it goes around in another circle. It's really a neat program, and she really was one of the spearheads for this, and you couple that with just all the different folks working together, and it makes for just a really neat program. I mean, I'm really happy to be a part of it. You know, I never would have met anybody at the food bank before. These cattle ranchers who donate the heads of cattle are just the salt of the earth, and so to be a part of all that is really a unique thing for me, and yeah, wonderful to be a part of Sonoma County.
So Rich, people already obviously enjoy drinking beer, and now they have another reason to enjoy if they drink your beer.
Rich, I haven't been to Cloverdale in, oh, I don't know. I drove through it just a couple of years ago, but the Cloverdale is in northern Sonoma County, and if I understand correctly, it will be at the far northern end of the SMART train, which is the Sonoma Marin area rapid transit system, mm-hmm, that is being, yep, developed. That will put Cloverdale connected by a mass transit system to the rest of the Bay Area.
Mm-hmm.
Are you expecting a lot of growth in the Cloverdale area after that happens?
Well, yes, and you know, there's always fear with growth, right? And it is, it's an older community, and it's also a small little town that's surrounded, you know, just geographically, it can't get that big.
Yeah.
And so the hope is yes. We're the farthest northern Sonoma County town, and it's kind of, you know, it's the gateway to the Redwoods before you head up to Mendocino and Humboldt County. And it's probably going to be 4 or 5 years before we get SMART up there,
mm-hmm,
but it's really going to change just even the way that I get to go to work. And it's really going to allow, you know, we're becoming more like you would see when you go to Germany or Europe or,
oh yeah,
mm-hmm, the UK, where you can get everywhere. And just imagine for me, I'm going to be able to, you know, ride my bike down to my pub in Healdsburg, which we have a pub and brewery there.
Oh, you lucky dog. I love Healdsburg.
Hop on a train and literally go down and watch a ball game in San Francisco or head up north. And I think that's going to be part of the real charm when this gets in place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're really working, too, to try to make sure that the rail component is part of SMART. And my distributor down in Petaluma is literally off one of the rail spurs.
Oh.
And it's my hope that we'll be able to, ship beer via rail at some point, or even bring in grain from, the port of Oakland, say some of our grain that comes in from the UK, and have it run by rail. So this is a long-term thing for Sonoma County. And when it finally gets all in play, it's going to really... It's going to be a real positive.
Yeah, I think it's fantastic. I grew up in Marin, and as you well know, Marin and Sonoma did not sign on to the big BART expansion when BART went in the late 60s, early 70s, yeah, and then any of the expansions since then have not included Marin or Sonoma counties. And so this will be the first sort of light rail system for the North Bay, which will terminus, I believe, in Larkspur. So you can jump on the ferry and take it right over to San Francisco. And they do have, the, like you mentioned, those special ferries that will drop you off at AT&T Park to watch a game. I love that idea, mm-hmm, because then you can enjoy the beer at the park, which they have some really fantastic brews there. And not have to worry about driving. Hey, Rich, looking at the pictures that you shared with us regarding this grain operation that you're doing with the Redwood Empire Food Bank of Sonoma County, and people, I should mention, can see these pictures as well by watching our video simulcast, which we offer online at eatdrinkexplore.com, reminds me of when I was a manager at the Marin Brewing Company in the early 90s, and I would have to dump these giant bags of grain, physically, mm-hmm, lift these bags, rip them open, dump them into the grist or the mill, I'm not sure what it's called, and then it would dump it down into the mash tun. Meanwhile, you are standing above something that is boiling, so steam is coming up, and you have all this fine dust from the grain that can actually kill you if you don't wear a mask, because it'll coat the inside of your lungs, and then when the moisture hits it, it expands and you basically suffocate to death. So try doing that after drinking beer the night before. It's not fun. But the whole brewery and the surrounding area smells then of the, you know, when the brewer is making a specific thing. And when I'm driving through a community and I
smell that?
All of a sudden all these like triggers go off and I'm like, okay, I got to find this place. Where is it? They're brewing.
It takes you back.
It does. Yeah. Rich, are you the gent that dumps these bags of grain, or do you have a different system set up?
Well, we still have to do it old school. And I got to tell you, I used to, my first original brewing job was at Marin Brewing Company.
Oh, you're kidding!
I was an apprentice there with
Grant.
And then Brendan hired me to help with the opening of Moylan.
Oh, that's awesome!
So what a fun time. But yes, I've got a special grain auger system that uses it in, but we have to dump in the fine ingredients.
You know exactly what I'm talking about, and the room that you did it in. BearRepublic.com. All those links available at Eat, Drink, Explore. Rich, thank you so much.
Cheers.
Randall White here, host of Eat, Drink, Explore Radio, with a tip for Central Coast Wine Tasting. Eberle Winery was recently voted Winery of the Year.